Hi, in this video we're going to learn how to use the virtual funnels. The virtual funnels is located here and it has two main functionalities. One is to track simple links. So we go to the virtual funnel generator up here, and in this pop-up we can add, we must add at least these two fields, the redirection, so is where your virtual funnel is going to go after tracking, and the keyword. So this is the minimum thing that you need to have. Okay, here we have some buttons. This is just to delete the field with this without having to highlight. This one is to paste something that you have in your clipboard, and this is to go to the redirection URL in case that you want to test that your redirection is correct. Okay, so this one has the delete paste, and this one has some other functionality that I'm going to show you in a second. So this is the basic and minimum link. So with this, that means that you intend to track this keyword. Facebook could be obviously any keyword, or different words. We're gonna use dashes automatically. The program put dashes. If you leave a space because you forget, it's gonna put dashes automatically. So anyway, here you click generate link. Now the link is generated, and you're gonna click copy to put this link somewhere. What is that somewhere? Well, that could be in a banner, could be in something that you a post that you do in Facebook. And in that case, what you're doing is to track that this particular keyword is gonna be showing in the. So I'm gonna click copy, okay, and I can actually paste it manually for testing. Okay, so what happens here is that, as you can see, it redirects, but to our website.
Welcome but, to the Credit Money Machine Web website.
But most importantly, it's going to be detected here. The triggering is actually when you pass through the dashboard somehow. So when you pass through the dashboard at some point later, and it's going to be tracked. Here, we click show all, okay, and we have this one right now. This is the one that we're tracking, and then we can have keyword stats, campaign stats, etc., etc. Okay, fine. Now, the second and most important use of the visual funnel generator is, so the second and most important use for the visual funnels is when you want to assign a marketing campaign automatically to a client. This is achieved through a marketing campaign and through a merch ID of the contact and an email. Of course, because in order to the program to know what is the client that is being tracked, you need to indicate. So let's go step by step. First, we're gonna try to find an ID, okay, of a marketing campaign. So we can go to the marketing campaign here, and let's say that I want to assign this marketing campaign to anyone that clicks on the email. Okay, so I'm gonna copy the ID, and I'm gonna click virtual funnel here. So I'm going there, and I click virtual funnel generator, and then I can click here to paste, and this MC button will show us the name of the marketing campaign, just for verification. You know what it is, since you just copied, but you know, just for checking. So this is the marketing ID. And then here, if you want to send to a specific contact, which would be, well, possible, a little bit weird, but possible, then you will put the ID of the contact here. Or you click in the ID button or click ID for merge field. So this one will be a merge field that will be substituted automatically when the person clicks on this link. So for example, we are going to generate the link, right? This is the link, as you can see, it contains this, so it's fine, and contains, this time it contains the marketing campaign ID. So I'm gonna copy the link, and in this case, I'm gonna go to the template manager to show a very, very simple example, trivial visual funnel sample. And the sample is here. So what I did here is to click here. Obviously, it can say a bunch of things. It can be even an HTML email that, as long as you know where to insert the link, so it can be anything. In this particular case, I'm gonna click here in links, or I can unlink, actually. You see, I unlinked just so we know from the beginning. So I'm going to link that link to that word. So I'm gonna click link, and I'm gonna put the link, okay? So now we have everything. I can put www if I want. That is not necessary, but I can. It's a URL link. The target is important, that is a new window, okay? That's it. So now I click OK, and I click Save, right? So what happens is when you send this email to a client, that client, I'm gonna do it with a preview template, which probably is not the best I can do. Let me see. Still is gonna work, but it's not ideal because this is a preview. This is not a real email that is being sent. But let's say that it was a full email with everything. It says, click here to get your 50 credit repair tips, okay? So I click on it, and it creates, as you can see, opens a page. So this is your customer clicking, and going to your website, not to ours, obviously, but to your website or any other place that you want to go. And now this click is being recorded in the visual funnels. But not only that, so we click here, show all. Okay, so we have it here, which is this one, you see, had been assigned. So this client, all these are fake clients, so this client with ID this, that you can go to this client by clicking here, or you can see it here, you can go to the client. You can unsubscribe it. You can copy the ID of the marketing campaigns, which we did before, right? And you can go to the marketing campaign by clicking the G. So now this client has assigned this marketing campaign. So if I go to this marketing campaign by clicking here, and you see this is the redirection. That could be obviously your website or other place that you want to go for whatever reason. And then the keyword, so it's being tracked as a keyword Facebook, as opposed to Facebook main page, for example, or something. So I'm gonna go to the marketing campaign here, and here you see we have this client assigned to this marketing campaign, which is the marketing campaign is credit tips to get leads, and that's pretty much that. The rest is automatic. And so this is extremely useful. You need to understand first with this simple video, and then try to adapt to your own needs, not the opposite. Don't think about your needs and then try to do it, but think about learning what I just said in the video, know what's going on, Sometimes you don't want or need a marketing campaign or a contact, as you can see here, because it's a simple, you want to track just the keyword somehow. Like you're putting a post in your Facebook, Twitter, whatever, and that post, you want to track how many people click on it, right? So you wouldn't be able to do that any other way, unless you're doing an ad, and still it wouldn't be inside your system, it would be outside. It would be trackable to a point. You need to trust that the other company, Facebook or any other, does the stats correctly. Usually that is true, but you never know. But this one, you kind of guarantee that the person clicked on that one, and you can count that in several ways. You can click here and select all the ones with Facebook, for example, and then you know that five people clicked, but they are different. You see, different in the sense that this one is usually, this is not going to be once yes and once no. Usually the keyword goes with the intention that you're gonna do. But because these are tests, some of them don't have anyone, and some of them have a client. Even though this client or test have different marketing campaigns. So this is the ID, and this is the name of the marketing campaign. Okay, so that's that. Enjoy it. This is a very, very powerful feature of our software, and enjoy it.